There is wind, there are matches, by Gerald Stern. A thousand times I have sat in restaurant windows, through mopping after mopping, letting the ammonia clear my brain and the music from the kitchens ruin my heart. I have sat there hiding my feelings from my neighbors, blowing smoke carefully into the ceiling, or after I gave that up, smiling over my empty plate like a tired wolf. Today I am sitting again at the long marble table at Horn and Hardarts, drinking my coffee and eating my burnt scrapple. This is the last place left, and everyone here knows it. If the lights were turned down, if the heat were turned off, if the banging of the dishes stopped, we would all go on, at least for a while. But then we would drift off, one by one, toward locust or pine. I feel this place is like a birch forest, about to go. There is wind. There are matches. There is snow. And it has been dark and dry for hundreds of years. I look at the chandelier waving in the glass, and the sticky sugar and the wet spoon. I take my handkerchief out for the sake of the 7 years we spent in Philadelphia, and the steps we sat on, and the tiny patches of lawn. I believe now more than I ever did before in my first poems, and more I feel that nothing was wasted, that the freezing nights were not a waste, that the long, dull walks and the boredom and the secret pity were not a waste. I leave the paper sitting front page up, beside the cold coffee, on top of the sugar, on top of the wet spoon, on top of the grease. I was born for one thing, and I can leave this place without bitterness and start my walk down Broad Street, past the churches and the tiny parking lots and the thrift stores. There was enough justice, and there was enough wisdom, although it would take the rest of my life, the next 200 years, to understand and explain it. And there was enough time, and there was enough affection, even if I did tear my tongue, begging the world for one more empty room and one more window with clean glass to let the light in on my last frenzy. I do the crow walking clumsily over his meat. I do the child sitting for his dessert. I do the poet asleep at his table, waiting for the sun to light up his forehead. I suddenly remember every ruined life, every betrayal, every desolation, as I walk past Tasker toward the city of Baltimore, banging my pencil on the iron fences, whistling Bach and Musinski through the closed blinds.